Thank the Founder!
Thank you.
What now?
This is drinking me.
We have to stop him.
Ready! Joshua!
Clive!
My brother.
I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
You're alive. We both are. Nothing else matters. I never dared hope that I would see this day.
Reunited at last.
Jill!
It is done. The demon that would tear our house apart is no more. Father.
The Mother Crystal. It's collapsing.
Right. We need to leave.
No. Wait. I owe him a debt.
Fine.
You there.
I just really don't want to say shit.
Little as you do. Take 20 minutes. Don't reinforce the walls.
Will be found. This
is our situation.
Report, Captain.
It could be some
fires of spray. Can nothing be done to call them off?
I regret not, Your Radiance. The Dragoons answer to none but His Imperial Highness. The Council is powerless to intervene.
We're hearing reports of rebel
madness is this, Theon.
Throughout the neighboring district.
Focus all efforts on extinguishing the fires around the capital. City can wait.
Don't dally, man! Go!
Your Radiance.
I want you to find out.
Make sure the doors are locked.
Make some movements.
By the light! Dion. Have you taken leave of your senses? Call off the Dragoons at once!
Fear not. The populace will come to no harm at their hands. I am here to save you, Father.
Save me?
A creeping darkness hides in the heart of Senbrek. It stems from your wife, the traitorous Annabella.
Not another word, Dion.
Father, Though you may not see it, the darkness has taken hold of you. It has made you forget yourself. But I bid you remember, there was a time when you ruled not with cruelty, but with compassion. Why now do you turn your back on your people? Why now do you seek to stoke the fires of war? You too have borne witness to this change, Your Eminences. And you know, as well as I, who is responsible for it. A puppet now sits upon the throne. But cut his strings, and the Master loses the power!
What?
Tion, you bear steel before your Emperor? Guards! Take him!
For every citizen who falls, another can be bred. For every home that burns, another can be built. Those were your words. But when the last of your citizens has fallen, and all of their homes have been reduced to ash, what will become of your empire, of its rulers, of your god? As the Mother Crystals crumble one by one, and the Blight sweeps in to claim all that we hold dear, our people look to their Emperor for protection. Yet he labors not to secure their futures, but to seize what is left of the Twins for himself! Even if it should come at the cost of everything his loyal citizens have labored to build!
Dion, you must understand.
A small price to pay, is it not? You've been blessed with great power, Dion. Enough to win me the world. So go, claim Valestia for me, brother. Father, how he doted on his children. That he would die to protect me was plain. It was but a matter of when.
You planned this?
You did well to endure so long. But you broke in the end, as I knew you would. And now Muthos approaches. Put him to the proof. I would see if he breaks. Go, Bahamut. Kinslayer.
You cannot stay here, Mother. Come. Take my hand.
Get away from me! This is all just a dream, just a bad dream! You will not take me, Shadow! You will not take me!
Mother.
Consciousness that weaves your wills together. Consciousness that blurs the boundary between your own will and that of others. Then we shall set you apart once more. The ties that bind you shall be severed, and humanity return to its proper place. By primogenesis shall a new age of reason begin.
Relax, Your Majesty. Don't you want to play? It's been a long time.
If that is your wish.
Men, you are as meek as all the others.
Such feeble creatures. Gifted the power of icons, yet slaves to fickle emotions which usher you to your doom. And so you bind your fragile wills with strands of consciousness.
The wretched handiwork of a wretched people.
The Sons of Fire were united at last, and for but a moment, their flame burned bright. Soon, Muthos shall become our perfect vessel.
And then shall the world be remade.
Not before the bonds are severed, of trust, of respect, of love. Only when every strand of consciousness is cut away, may Muthos return to our side. By primogenesis shall all be undone. Mankind shall be rid of his wretchedness, and Muthos of his will. But while he yet clings to it, he has the power to forge bonds anew. And so we bid you. Find Muthos. And sever everyone.
To destroy that which has no physical form, you ask the impossible.
There is nothing your black blade cannot cut, Odin. We shall unite with Muthos and bring forth a new world. So long as our vessel remains unclaimed by humanity.
It shall be done, Master. My will is yours.
Thank you.
How is your brother?
Asleep since I returned from the Dominion. Taya says he should be back on his feet soon enough. For a while, at least. She discovered something on his chest. A swelling, circled in stone.
The curse. For every mountain we climb, another rises up to greet us, doesn't it?
It's never ending. Even the sky seems to have grown tired of it all. Joshua. While he rests, I might as well see what Otto has to say. Hopefully it's nothing. But I should speak to Blackthorn just in case. wrong with Torgor? He seemed well enough when I last saw him. Trouble with the ledgers. Shouldn't he be asking Otto for help? See the pair that got hauled into time. I got your note. You think something's wrong with Torgor?
So you can read. Congratulations. But I didn't say I were wrong with him. I said something weren't right. He's not been eating my treats. He used to love cracking the bones from Molly's boiled brown, but now he won't so much as look at them. Didn't like him. Which is why I'm of a mind that his mind's on somewhat else. You've not been working him too hard, have you?
No harder than usual. Is that it, boy? Do you need a rest?
What was it you said he was? A frost wolf?
That's what the Lawsman seems to think.
Then maybe this all has something to do with whatever it is that's woken inside him.
I suppose things happen different since Rosaleth. Perhaps Harpocrates knows something.
Instead of everything, you mean? Perhaps.
It seems the hideaway has lost its appetite. Can you blame me?
Lawsman, I need to ask you about Torgor. Something's not right with him.
He isn't ill, is he?
I don't think so. But according to Lady Karen, he seems to have lost his appetite, which is certainly a new development. She says he's hardly been touching his bones of late, and she believes it may have something to do with what happened at Rosaleth Castle.
I rather think she might be right, though not about his appetite. All canids are instinctively inclined to crack open bones for the rich marrow that resides within, and I see no reason why a frost wolf should be any different. Accordingly, I suspect it is not a lack of appetite that afflicts Torgor, but a surfeit of it. If we assume that his newfound magics require additional nourishment to sustain, it may well be that the bones Lady Karen is accustomed to providing are no longer sufficient. Frost wolves, after all, habitually prey upon far larger animals, whose bones may yield altogether different nutrients. As to where one might find a suitable substitute, some antelopes that graze the meadows of eastern Rosaria have been known to grow to a size more than double that of their lesser cousins.
I don't recall ever seeing any that large.
And little wonder. The oldest and largest such creatures rarely leave the safety of the highlands for fear of predators. The last elder antelope sighting I recall hearing about took place near Cressida, and that was long before the village was abandoned.
Even so, it seems like a good place to start.
Good hunting, Clive.
Thank you.
say that? Tell me you saw that.
What do you make of them skies, then?
Otto, how fares the realm?
The realm? Oh, she's just fine. As long as you look past the fat storms at Mother Crystals and her skies are a roiling cesspit.
And Gav?
He's with your uncle in the Free Cities, helping Mid with her project. Sent an owl their way the moment the winds turned foul. Still waiting on a reply, though.
Do you have any good news?
Well, that depends on your definition of good.
All right, fine. What do you suggest we do?
Oh, no, I'm just the messenger. I'll leave the scheme into those more suited to the task. Could be that Lady Vivian and Old Tomes have their own thoughts on the current state of things. Could be that they don't. It certainly can't hurt to ask.
I suppose not.
How is it that every one of your little excursions presages some inexplicable catastrophe? Not that you are to blame for the Dominion's fate. No one could have predicted the actions of the Crown Prince.
I'm sorry I couldn't save your home.
My countrymen are stronger than you think. A few toppled clock towers won't break their spirits. They'll be back on their feet in no time.
I hope so.
Look at us. Bluer than a pair of bog crabs. Tempting though it may be, sulking will not help us find a solution to this mess.
You believe there's one to be found?
I don't know. But I am certain we're more likely to find it if we first examine the facts. Beneath these darkened skies, fear and confusion reign over Valisthea. Oh, the lands around the fallen Mother Crystals had already begun to wilt for want of ether. But not like this. Crystals that filled wells and fueled furnaces, now nothing but pretty shards of rock. And those that hang from the people's necks cast nary a glimmer of light to keep the dark at bay. It is only a matter of time before the common folk convince themselves that the end of days is upon us. Yet I fear a swift end is more than we can hope for. While most of the world thirsts for ether, the remainder drowns in it, spawning Akashic in droves. And amidst the hordes of mindless beasts, with magics as like to fail as function, even the strongest